Summoned by Dean Stormleaf's urgent message. You doubt this is about the seating arrangements. It looks like the preparations for the grand event are underway. Yet the servants stand idle, clearly nervous. An ominous hush blankets. Dean stands at the podium gazing at a strange light that flickers at the edge. Looks like the air itself has been torn. As if it were a piece of paper. Seems that this part of Morgrave is becoming coterminous with some plane I cannot yet identify. Fascinating. Please approach the tear. What will be. But haste may help you. As you approach the tear in space, a chill envelops you. A dark presence lures. The ethereal form of Vector towers over you. Early to your own party? And here I was hoping to surprise you. No matter. Let us commence with the festivities. The Terran space begins to widen. It's a portal, a kind you've never seen before. You feel a blast of heat as something very large steps through. Something familiar. The Baylor's voice booms.
I return to finish what I started. This realm will burn.
Vecna purrs. Yes. And this thrice-cursed universe will find a kingdom. I've enchanted your blade to allow it to cut a wider path for your army. Begin your conquest. No one stands in the way.
Baylor needs little convincing. By. You can hear its guttural chant as more rifts begin to form.
See me. Let's hurry before.
Thank you.
Baylor falls back to the first portal to make its final stand.
Aid me, Vecna, and I will serve you for centuries more. I swear it!
Vecna chuckles. Heroes. A Baylor of bodies is a cage of the uncontrolled maelstrom of its rage. The building shakes. The furious demon fire releases below you. The foundation of Morgrave's Tower holds true. Stand unseen. Vecna hisses in disgust as he fades. Savor your victory while you can, Worms. In time, all will be mine. You can only postpone. minds are as still as only stone can be. Chill as you approach this pile of bones. You are overwhelmed by the silence, and yet feel a strange urge to speak. It's as if the skull is listening, waiting to hear something. Barrier to the Forgotten Swamps. As the last rune is set alight, the way forward is open. Beast in the maze wasn't inclined to follow you. Maybe you can take a brief pause before braving the volcano. You find yourself before the legendary Ghost Flame. She appears to be merely a human woman in her prime, with only a touch of greenish flame to hint at her power. And yet she is feared by the islanders more than any great beast that stalks the Isle of Dread. Closer inspection shows that the Ghost Flame is locked in some kind of trance. Shrouded in a protective shadow, she shakes her head as if she was arguing with herself, or with someone unseen. The skeleton abruptly gestures as if to cast a spell. The undead scream with voices racked with torment.
Anders! It's the only way!
My clever.
Her eyes still closed. The Ghost Flame's voice is tinged with regret.
These toys cannot help us escape this path. Not even death can break our bonds.
Ghost Flame's undead rise to attack, but she remains behind her shield, muttering once again. A burning skeleton awaits its end. fire igniting in her hands.
Would it surprise you to learn that I was once an adventurer like you? And look at me now. Look at my comrades. This is the cost. Someone wants to collect you. He'll make you like us. Take my advice. Die while you still can.
Thank you.
As for you, adventurers, I doubt that Vecna is done with you. So best of luck with that.
What is this blasphemy? The speaking of secrets, the breaking of a covenant. Such insolence will not go unpunished. You were to destroy my pawn, not free her. Her fate was marked.
What kind of ore hides within this little chest?
Thank you. At the Valley of the Door to Faraway. Ahead, Hawthorne and Harrison argue from the relative safety of their respective circles of power. The barrier in the southeast fades. The corrupted unicorns vanish as if on cue. The archfey and the dryad pause. Hawthorne trembles slightly. The corrupted unicorn's blows have clearly shaken her. Hearsome frowns with disappointment.
Well played, dear Sprouts. But the door yields to my will ever so slightly. Let's see what comes through.
At Hearsome's command, giant fiery insects pour out of the door to Faraway.
Help! Rightly they burn.
Go forth, honored guests! To the north! To the south! Where doors to Eladrin towns await you!
Stop them if you can!
Hawthorne cries.
But we must stay focused on the Dota Stones, or all is lost.
The barrier in the southwest fades.
Most Eladrin have to go. A true, I am the true hero. Once they're gone, the world will know. I am right, let nature flow.
Didn't you ever know it's how to boast, complain, and moan? When this ends, you'll be alone, crouching on your broken throne.
Rose and Ladron have to go. I am the hero.
Is once they're gone, the world
will know.
His head toward the door to Faraway. Hawthorne sways, obviously drained. Dark energies cling to her form.
Well, what's that I hear? Another guest knocking on the door. What great beast approaches now, I wonder?
A monstrous furry beast leaps through the door with a loud pop. Is that a chipmunk?
Oh, don't you dare laugh at me, old flame. I can work with any clay I am given. Rodent! You lust for me, God, no more. Instead, you'll only shake by a lad's blood.
Now go forth and bite someone. Litter!
The barrier in the northeast fades.
Lamania's and private lands offered me the perfect land. A wondrous opportunity to crush a Latin royalty.
But who are you to decide who in this realm survives? You think because you're an archfey that we will let them die?
Look at you, what you've become. They have you trapped under their thumb, twisted you with all their lies. Their palaces corrupt our skies. Your bitterness pollutes your leaves. You were never truly free. You never stray far from your tree. Admit it, you wish you were me.
You never listen, never learn, despite how long it's been. Though I feel nothing towards you now, my bark was never thin. I've met the Fae of Robinwood. I've known them as you never could. And through it all, for matter good, every challenge we've withstood.
A tiny form,
a loud roar echoes from the door. Pearsome and Hawthorne pause and turn toward the noise. The dryad's movements are labored. The Vorpal chipmunk turns tail. It skitters back through the door to its home plane, somewhat the worse for wear. A gigantic bear peers out from the doorway. Pearsome cackles with glee.
Yes! Shouldn't it be larger?
No, never mind.
That will do.
Off you go, my pet.
The Archfey and the Dryad resume their tour.
Most Eladrin have to go. A true, I am the true hero. Once they're gone, the world will know. I am right, let nature flow.
The only thing you've ever known is how to boast, complain, and moan. When this ends, you'll be alone.
Rose and Ladron have to go. A true, I
Let's go!
You approve I am a true hero. Once they've gone the world will go.
But away!
Let nature flow.
The song stops yet again. As the last doorstone comes into balance.
Well done,
cries Hawthorne.
Rally to me so we can end this.
Roaring in pain, the gigantic bear flees back from where it came. An answering roar thrums distantly from beyond the threshold. The ground begins to tremble with the steady thump of footsteps coming from below. For Fomorian rips himself out of the ground. From its terrible eye. Hawthorne shudders in fear, maimed by the giant's attack.
It's been all that I haven't enjoyed our tete-a-tete,
but this brave man's star deserves a solo performance.
Ah!
He's done.
Ah!
I can't say that. I'm sorry. Seeing you knocked to the ground, I knew that this would happen in this battle for the sound. But what shall our great heroes do as you face certain doom? Will they grovel at my feet or stand defiant through and through? You claim I'm the villain. Well, you crave a villain. Have a taste. Beast, what come by the king has always been your fate. There is only one way that this fable will be told. If you insist on fighting me, soon you'll learn your role.
As your strikes continue raining down on him.
Satyr Prince, aid me! Before these outlanders cut me to the quick! Here, sir!
The king shouts.
We were to end the Eladrin plague together as allies. Was I but a tool in your scheme?
Brethren, it's not. And I, the one who strums your strings. But benefits us both, surely.
After all, the Eladrin will be destroyed.
The Fomorian's eye flares.
Treacherous goat! I curse you! Fancy yourself the master of song! No longer shall you master a note!
Hearsome's tune suddenly turns sour. His fine fiddling is replaced with jarring discord. Panic seizes him.
What have you done?
My fiddle.
You broke it!
No, worse. You've stolen my musical prowess.
It cannot be!
Now, who's played who, Archfey?
Sneers the Fomorian king as he retreats, fading into shadow like a bad memory. Scar's herd follows, vanishing, leaving no other threat. Free of the Fomorian's gaze, Hawthorne rises, defiant.
Let me take the finale then,
she cries.
You tried your best to doubt me, but darling, did you know that you could never fool me? You're not a hero! And now that you've been dealt your doom, you'll see what always has been true. I have never, we have never, ever needed you!
As the song's last note echoes through the valley, the wind blows, and the door to Faraway closes with a sigh. Victory is yours.
Thank you.
Can't you find more robust allies? A giant, perhaps? Or at least a troll?
I'm stuck in the fucking corner for some reason, so... There he goes.
Thank you.
navigate your way through the lower cogs and arrive at your destination. The hidden Caneth facility and all of its secrets await you in the darkness ahead. The manners of their deaths seem to be quite varied. Through the wreckage, you spot a magic mouth mounted on the wall. The portal takes you to an observation room overlooking a laboratory filled with strange equipment. Lieutenant Dane is here, looking down on a familiar foe. Mistwalker turns to face you, his expression serene.
Our would-be heroes have arrived as expected. Helma, keep to the gate. While you're busy, we'll give our guests the battle they surely seek.
A cloud of corrosive green energy manifests around his body. The sharp tang of acid fills the air.
Hold on, my champion. Your leader is here to aid you. Raise, O Revenant, and return to the battle.
50.
Reanimation later.
Mistwalker falls to his knees. Puzzled frown marring his chiseled features. He looks up to address you.
I have indeed fallen from my divine origins. I suppose I must fall a little farther still, continue on my path. Lord from beyond the veil, hear me, my old rival, black-blooded fiend, hear my voice.
Darkness and fire churn together.
And
a swirling portal tears open in front of the fallen angel, and a horned figure steps through and speaks.
Your call has been answered, Celestial. Lord's behest.
The goblin falls, and a cloud of flapping white energy manifests around his body. Lightning flashes within.
Redoubled your efforts on the gate. This path is dark, but we will still
walk on. There is a
devil's goblin will slow and rot. Rest in safety.
Your world is not worth this.
With a flick of his wings, he vanishes, only to reappear on a ledge above you. He seems content to watch the battle for now. Blistering red energy manifests around his body. The area ignites into flame.
They caught you, Zalkis. My gift extinguished. Rest for now, demon spirit.
Thank you. battery! Cries Helmer in frustration. The gnome artificer steps away from the gate controls.
This gig is blown, boss. I'm out.
She reads a scroll and then vanishes in a shimmer of blue light. Mistwalker calls to his infernal ally.
Emissary, your aid is not enough. I know your lord commands great power. We need more here.
Recall my lord's offer,
says the devil emissary.
Accept it in full. Then the power to smite these pests will be.
Walker nods slowly.
I understand. This will be a dark day, but it may lead back to the light in the end. Emissary, accept your lord's offer. Do you hear me, Dark One? I accept your conditions. I, Caspian Mistwalker, seal our pact.
Dark purple flames erupt from Mistwalker. They unfold into a pair of flaming skeletal wings. He laughs.
It was such a foul thing to be done to me. It feels good to see me. Fallen and tiny dwarf has new power and return to me.
Then let's try to recover from your little accident.
cab.
You see a magical barrier guarded by an unusual group. A mixture of City Watch and Aranel Elves of the Undying Court. An imposing elf beckons to you impatiently. Those forge rates begin to grow in size. A mob of fangs stock still as if in a trance. They are not alone. The wills of these cogdwellers have been completely broken. It seems the forge rates are more than just a physical threat. There's not much you can do for these poor souls. Your best hope is to end the forge rate's infestation at its source. With the elevator secure, you may now take a moment to regroup before proceeding to the foundry. You may not get a chance to rest or turn back after this point. Prepare yourselves.
Bionitas Tears, is that help arriving? About time!
An elderly woman in singed clothes squats close to a complex crystal display.
I'm Chief Engineer Narva. Now quit gawking and come help me. Listen. That lava is rising. We can drain it, but we've got to restart the furnaces first. Did someone come here and read the main panel? Steam blast got my eyes, it's all a blur. This console has a readout for each furnace by number. The actual furnace controls are over on the side. You need to set each furnace array to match the color patterns here, then pull the main breaker. That's the great big heavy lever on the right side. As you enter the furnace, fortress rise from the floor. Their whispers promise the agony of the flame. Levers and gears lock into place as you restore the furnace to its proper configuration. There's a low rumble, and the lava level begins to drop. As your Forge Wraith opponents fade from view, their whispers fade with them. For a moment, the rumble of machinery is the only sound. Well, that wasn't so hard.
Says Narva with a grin. Yet as soon as the words leave her lips, the whole cavern begins to shake. A vast shape stirs deeply into the world, and the whispers begin again. A molten giant. A chorus of cries and shrieks echoing from its massive form. All the poor souls lost to Vaunt's greed have manifested into this. A creature that exists only for vengeance. The giant turns its gaze towards you. The countless souls that comprise the thing stop their shrieking to see its form.
Burn.
They say.
Instructs Narva. Just make sure each tank's controllers point away from itself. Green is good. Now hurry. Another wave of Cog's fanatics pours from the elevator shafts. You have restored the coolant tanks. Another wave of Cog's fanatics pours from the elevator shafts. The good news is, the lava is dry, says Narva. The bad news is, I think that thing's coming back. My last dance, but you lot fooled us through. All right, me Tyros, come to me to get your hazard pay. You sure have earned it.
Thank you.
begins anew. Begins anew.